allowing the weight gain to kind of take control of my life, I grabbed a hold of what was happening to my body as soon as I could, and I kind of got it under control right away. And I think doing that back then is what helped me maintain the body that I do have today. Although I do still experience weight gain, especially with going through IVF and going through infertility and taking hormones and all of that stuff that I'm doing today, I am still experiencing it. But since I lead a very healthy, almost vegan lifestyle that is lactose and gluten-free, I have been able to obtain it. But I know that when the day comes that I'm not on top of what I eat and how I exercise, I know that I am definitely in a position to be a person who gains weight very quickly and very easily, and that sucks. I've been having irregular periods since my first period, and I still have irregular periods today. I had my first period when I was about 14. I was in the 8th grade going into 9th grade, and then after that I didn't have another period for 6 months, and then after that it took another 4 months, and that's pretty much still the same today. I have a period from every 4 to 6 months, and that is a big part of why my husband and I are having issues with infertility, because without a period I can't ovulate, and if I do ovulate I don't know when I'm ovulating. So that is what makes PCOS and trying to get pregnant really difficult, is the fact that periods happen whenever they want and you don't know when. So that's really inconvenient. The next one that I want to talk about is acne. As you can see, my skin is pretty clear, but I honestly was at a point in my life at once where I could have never imagined having the skin that I have today. I don't even know if I could put into words how bad my acne has been in my life. I have no pictures, I have no evidence of the acne that I have had in my life, because I did not take pictures during that time, and if I did have a picture, I threw it away because I couldn't handle it. I had acne and pimples from a young age throughout my life. I struggled with little pimples here and there, but I wouldn't say that in middle school and in high school I would call it acne. I just had breakouts often. And then I remember when I was 19, during that time period of being 19 is kind of when everything happened to me. It happened all at once, the weight gain, the acne, just everything all happened at once. It was like a big explosion. But I remember going to the doctor and going because of my irregular periods, trying to get more information. And the doctor didn't really ask me any questions or anything, just said, okay, you probably have PCOS. Didn't check my hormones, didn't do anything, just nothing. And just gave me some birth control that was called Lolo Estrin. I took Lolo Estrin birth control for 2 weeks and my face just exploded. I mean, there was not one part of my face that was not covered in acne, and I'm not exaggerating, just please trust me on this. It was so bad and so painful, cystic acne, and it was one of the worst parts about my PCOS experience. It was a really difficult time for me. I ended up going on Accutane for 6 months, and now here I am. When I tell you that I could have never imagined that I would have such clear skin, I'm not even joking. It was so bad, and I was really miserable, and it was so difficult to take that medication and go through that. I don't really recommend it. That medicine is very difficult to take and to go through. There's a lot of side effects that come along with it, so